In this video, we're continuing on with the Infinite Geometry KutaSoftware free worksheet, Simplifying Square Roots. Now remember, the key to simplifying square roots is to find that perfect square that's a multiple of the number within the square root. If that seems confusing to you, go back to the previous videos where I do a more in-depth explanation. And if you're still confused, please feel free to comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. But let's start with number 17. Hopefully by now, you're able to recognize that 36 is a perfect square. 6 times 6 is 36. So we can rewrite this as 2 times the square root of 6 squared. Remember, the square root of some number squared, the square root cancels out that exponent, so it's just that whole number. So we can pull out that 6 to get 2 times 6, which is a whole number 12. So 2 times the square root of 36 is 12. Moving on to number 18, we can rewrite this as 9 times the square root of 125, and that 125 is equal to 25 times 5. And 25, we know, is 5 squared. So that's 9 times the square root of 5 squared times 5. Breaking up that square root, we get 9 times the square root of 5 squared times the square root of 5. The square root of 5 squared we know is 5. So we'll have 9 times 5 times the square root of 5. 9 times 5 is 45. And we still have to multiply that 45 by the square root of 5. So 45 times the square root of 5 is the solution in number 18. And we know that this is as simplified as far as it can be because there is no perfect square that can fit into 5 evenly. In number 19, we have 8 times the square root of 27. 27 can be broken up into 9 times 3. So we'll have 8 times the square root of 9 times 3. That's equal to 8 times the square root of 27. That 9 is our perfect square. So we'll have 8 times the square root of 3 squared times 3, since 3 squared equals 9. Breaking up this radical, we'll have 8 times the square root of 3 squared times the square root of 3. The square root of 3 squared is 3, so we'll have 8 times the whole number 3 times the square root of 3. 8 times 3 is 24, so we'll have 24 times the square root of 3 as our final answer in number 19. In number 20, we have 12 times the square root of 1,764. So let's go ahead and break up 1,764. 1,764 we can rewrite as, well, let's see which perfect square goes into it evenly. 4 goes into 1,764 evenly. We can write that as 4 times 441, since 4 times 441 is equal to 1,764. However, 441, I know we can fit a perfect square into that. So we have 4 times, let's see what perfect square goes into 441. 4 does not go into 441. 9 does go into 441. Let's rewrite 441 as 9 times 49. So 1,764 equals 4 times 9 times 49. Since 9 times 49 is 441, and 4 times 441 is 1,764. So now, not only do I have one perfect square, I went from having one perfect square to having two perfect squares, but if you look, 49 is also a perfect square. 49 is 7 squared. So let's rewrite 1,764 as 2 squared, since 2 squared is equal to 4, times 3 squared, since 3 squared is equal to 9, times 7 squared, since 7 squared is 49. So 1,764 is equal to 2 squared times 3 squared times 7 squared. And if you want to double check, go ahead and enter that into your calculator. So what I'm going to do is plug in all these perfect squares in for 1,764 in our expression. So I'll have 12 times the square root of 2 squared times 3 squared times 7 squared. and I can break up this radical. 12 times the square root of 2 squared times the square root of 3 squared times the square root of 7 squared. From there, we'll get 12 times the square root of 2 squared is 2, times the square root of 3 squared is 3, times the square root of 7 squared is 7. So I'll have 12 times 2, which is 24. 24 times 3 is 72, and multiplying that by 7 is 504. So 504 is my solution in number 20, since 12 times 2 times 3 times 7 is 504. Let's move on to 21. In 21, we have 3 times the square root of 900. I know that 100 goes into 900 evenly, and 100 is also a perfect square. So I can rewrite this as 3 times the square root of 100 times 9, since 100 times 9 equals 900. However, not only did I wind up getting that 100 was a perfect square, but 9 is also a perfect square. So I can rewrite this as 3 times the square root of 10 squared times 3 squared, since 10 squared equals 100 and 3 squared equals 9. When I break up the square root, I'll get 3 times the square root of 10 squared times the square root of 3 squared, which I know is 3 times 10 times 3. 3 times 10 is 30. 30 times 3 is 90. So the solution in number 21 is 90. Let's move on to number 27. I'm going to rewrite 2,535. Doing trial and error in your calculator, the smallest perfect square that goes into 2,535 is 13 squared. 13 squared is 169. 169 times 15 will give us 2,535. So knowing that 169 is 13 squared, let's write this as 7 times the square root of 13 squared times 15. Looking at 15, there's no perfect square that can go into 15 evenly. So let's go ahead and break up this radical and simplify. We'll have 7 times the square root of 13 squared times the square root of 15. So that's going to be 7 times the square root of 13 squared is 13 times the square root of 15. 7 times 13 is 91, and we're still multiplying that by the square root of 15. So our solution for number 22 is 91 times the square root of 15. Let's move on to number 23. Let's see what perfect squares can go into 1,215. 1,215 can be rewritten as 9 times 135, where 9 is that perfect square. So we can rewrite this as 11 times the square root of 3 squared times 135. However, there's still a perfect square that can fit in 135. Let's figure that out. So we have 11 times the square root of 3 squared times, let's see what we can break 135 up into. 135 is also divisible by 9, and that would be 9 times 15, where 9 is our perfect square. So now we can write 11 times the square root of 3 squared times 3 squared, since 3 squared is equal to 9, times 15. And we know we cannot break 15 up anymore, since there's no perfect square that goes into 15. So let's simplify. Breaking up this square root, we'll have 11 times the square root of 3 squared times the square root of 3 squared times the square root of 15. That will be 11 times 3 times 3 times the square root of 15. 11 times 3 is 33. Multiply that by 3, and that's 99. So we'll get 99 times the square root of 15 as our final answer in number 23. And finally, on to number 24. But before I go over the answer to this, please remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel and give me a thumbs up for this video. And as always, if you have any questions or you need a problem clarified, please leave a comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. So, going over the answer to number 24. we have 2 times the square root of 200. We know that 200 is divisible by 100. So we can rewrite this as 2 square root of 100 times 2. Since 100 is a perfect square, we can rewrite that as 2 times the square root of 10 squared times 2. There's no perfect square that can fit into 2. Let's go ahead and simplify to reach our answer. We can break this up into 2 times the square root of 10 squared times the square root of 2. That would leave us as 2 times 10 times the square root of 2, which 2 times 10 is 20, and we're left with multiplying 20 by the square root of 2. 20 times the square root of 2 is the solution in number 24. And with that, we wrap up the Simplifying Square Roots worksheet.